Hello guys and welcome to a new video. So I recently got the Red Magic 7 and I'll be making a quick review video because I know this brand is a popular choice for many players, not just in COD but also other mobile games. So I'll go through the tech specs first and then I'll be showing you a quick gameplay with this device so that you can see the performance for yourself. I hope you guys find it useful and let's get started. So there are three different versions of Red Magic 7: the Obsidian, the Pulsar, and the Supernova. The one I have with me is the Obsidian, and it comes with 12 gigs of RAM and 128 gigs of storage. And honestly, it's all you need. It already gives an insane gaming experience. But if you have the extra cash, then you can go for the Pulsar or the Supernova. They're all worth the price. The box itself is eye-catching. We got this badass character right here and he kind of reminds me of FTL from COD. So we have the 65 watts fast charger to charge the 4500 milliamps battery. It also comes with a plastic cover for a bit of protection. And finally, the legend himself. Let's start with what makes this phone special and why it's considered one of the best gaming phones in the market. First of all, the powerful chipset. A Snapdragon 8, which gives an extra 30% performance compared to the Red Magic 6. Then we got the 6.8 inches AMOLED Full HD display with a refresh rate that goes up to 165 Hz, which is the highest on a mobile phone. Next, we have the Ice 8 cooling system, which is another thing they improved with many different ways to cool down the device, including a 20,000 RPM high-speed turbofan that not only gives better cooling, but also with 40% less noise. And finally, the 500Hz shoulder triggers. The best thing about them, unlike many other gaming phones, they're built in the device itself and not popping out. These triggers have an insane fast response time of only 8 milliseconds. They even come with their own sensitivity option to control the pressure needed to trigger them. And it makes sure that you don't press them by accident. We also have the red button, which was available in the Red Magic 6. And once activated, you will enter gaming mode. So it allocates the device resources towards providing the best gaming experience for you, as well as blocking any type of interference like calls or notifications. I'm gonna start with the most important aspect in the game, which is the graphics. So there is no surprise that this device supports the maximum graphics possible in both multiplayer and battle royale, with all options activated. We arrived to the real test, and I wanted to give this device the hardest test possible. So I set the graphics to very high and the frame rate to max. And during the games I played, the FPS was stable at around 60. I haven't faced any heat issues and I didn't get a single frame drop or a freeze. It was pretty much the smoothest gaming experience I ever had on a mobile phone. So the final question here, is this device worth it or not? And the answer is obvious. The specs you're getting for the price you're paying is definitely worth it. And I highly recommend this device, not only for COD, but every other mobile game. I hope that whoever planning to buy this phone find this video useful. And now only one thing is remaining, which is the gameplay. If you're here for an intense gameplay, then sorry to tell you that it's not that intense. I mean, it's not that bad, but my goal here was to show the device performance. So I didn't really focus on getting a good gameplay. Also, don't expect much from me. Last time I played on a mobile phone was on Rules of Survival. That was around 4 years ago, but I'll do my best. It's a good challenge for me, especially while recording a handcam. And speaking of handcams, you guys already know that I'm bad with it because I keep moving my hands around. I mean, the start was good, but then as the game started to get more and more intense, I found myself out of the camera range. So I'll only show the decent parts of the handcam. As for the HUD layout, I'll be using this one. It's similar to my iPad HUD, but for a smaller screen. I hope you guys enjoy and I'll see you in the next video. Peace.
Enemy down. Enemy eliminated. Enemy down. Enemy eliminated.
Enemy down.